the psalm and gospel reading, or gospel passage just read, are some of the readings for the Feast of the Transfiguration, that event in which Jesus was transfigured upon a mountaintop as Moses and Elijah stood with him, and which Jesus' disciples, Peter, James, and John, watched. It is that event which I like to call the light bulb moment of Jesus, for we are told that the appearance of Jesus' face changed, and his clothes became dazzling white. The event of the Transfiguration is so important that the church celebrates the momentous occasion the last Sunday after the Epiphany, the Sunday before Ash Wednesday, as Transfiguration Sunday. And there is also the Feast of the Transfiguration, which the church celebrates on August 6th, this coming Friday. And this scene gives us what could be seen as the three most important persons in Israel's history who played pivotal roles in the life-altering and changing points in the lives of the Hebrew people. Moses represented the law, and Elijah represented the prophets. The Old Testament, the Hebrew scriptures, are referred to often as the law and the prophets when the Jews spoke of God's revelation to his people. God spoke through the law, the Ten Commandments, as given to Moses on Mount Sinai. And God spoke through the prophets, represented here by Elijah, one of the premier prophets of all time. Moses was the one who led the Hebrew people out of slavery in Egypt, spending 40 days, a period of time, with God on a mountaintop. And Elijah represented all the prophets who spoke on God's behalf, revealing God's truth. Elijah would also encounter God on the same mountaintop where Moses met him. And then there is Jesus, who was standing with Moses and Elijah as they spoke about his departure. Here was Jesus, who was the Word himself. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus is the fulfillment, the completion, the consummation of the Word. And he embodies the Word in every word of God that has ever spoken. He came as the fulfillment of the law, the same law that Moses received, not to abolish the law, but to fulfill it. And he was the fulfillment of the prophecies that were ever told. Jesus was God being revealed in all his glory. And thus the symbolism of Moses and Elijah with Jesus on that day as they stood on the mountaintop where the event of the Transfiguration took place was that they were both pointing to the one who was to come, the one who was the fulfillment of all of God's promises and covenants, the one who was God's son, God's chosen, and they needed to listen to him. And after the Transfiguration experience took place and they were leaving, Peter did not wish to leave without making it an occasion to remember. Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah," not knowing what he said. It is almost like our wanting to take pictures when significant events or experiences or occasions take place in our lives. Or like two persons in love who carve a heart in the trunk of a tree and transcribe their initials. Or it may be a place we wish we could stay for a very long time, if not for the rest of our lives. In other words, we wish to have something to remember the time we spent there. And that's what Peter wanted. But what are we to glean from the story of the Transfiguration? What is it saying to us today? And I will share just two important points that I want us to capture in this story. The first is is that no matter how wonderful or important, how perfect or surreal some moments in our lives are, they are just that, moments. No matter how wonderful or important, how perfect or surreal some moments in our lives are, they're just moments. Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you and one for Moses and one for Elijah, Peter said. And we gather from the passage that Jesus dismissed the idea and instead they kept silent and in those days told no one any of the things they had seen. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 17 and verse 9 tells us that Jesus himself told them to tell no one of the vision until he had risen. And this moment, although a beautiful one which the three disciples would experience, was only temporary. And Jesus does not even want Peter to build any remembrances of the event. It is time to get back to reality as far as Jesus is concerned. It's like going on a vacation and staying in a hotel or being on a cruise, and you are pampered. You are having all your meals prepared, your bed made up, your room clean, your laundry done, relaxing and resting as much as you like, and you wish it will never end. You are having this first-class treatment which you will not get when you return home. But we have to leave the hotel. We have to get off the ship. The vacation must come to an end. And then it's back to reality. It was in the past, and as much as we will wish to stay in that moment, it is history. We have to return to the moments that are real, whether they are satisfactory or disappointing, encouraging or frustrating, painful or painless, interesting or boring. The moments which are easy and those that are challenging. And Peter wanted to stay so much so that he wanted to erect mementos of the occasion. But even he too had to return to the types of moments of which we prefer not to be a part. And Jesus desires us not to dwell on the past, but to be mindful of the present and hopeful for the future. And the second point has to do with what does it mean to be transfigured? What really happened when Jesus was transfigured? What really happened was that who Jesus is on the inside was physically revealed on the outside. Who Jesus was on the inside was physically revealed on the outside. His physical appearance, that bright light bulb and glowing appearance, tells us something about his identity, about who he is, that he is God's Son, the chosen one, that we are to listen to him. Oftentimes we focus on the outside, the externals, on the outward appearance of ourselves, so we all get pretty up and look nice. And we focus on the outside. We focus on the outside of our homes. And we focus on the outside of ourselves. And we focus on the outside of our vehicles. But God wants us to change on the inside, the internals, the kind of person we really are. What we say to others and how we say it determines what comes from inside of us. It was in Matthew's Gospel that Jesus tells us that it is not what goes into our mouths that makes us unclean, it is what comes out of our mouths that makes us unclean. So remember, what we are on the inside is revealed on the outside. Amen.